So in this short video, I hope to show you how easy it is to integrate Python code into Pipeline Pilot using the Jupyter Notebooks component. The protocol starts with an SD reader and some property calculations. It happens that those are properties that I require for my calculation, so I do those up front. Now, I pull in the Python Jupyter Notebook component and I run the protocol. Now, I've run that before I've written a line of Python code, and that is because inside the Python Jupyter Notebook component, the notebook requires that the data in the pipeline has been cached before we can start using it, as we might expect with Jupyter, i.e. interactively through the code. So in this case, I can see it's given me up at the top a quick summary script that tells me, hey, this is what your data kind of looks like at the moment. You can see we've got CASRN, we've got index, and a few properties that I've calculated. Now, this is when I start to develop my code. And so I already have an algorithm that I've already created, and in this case, it's very simple. But hopefully you can see by the concepts used that this could be extended quite a lot into machine learning and statistical analysis and so forth. In my case, I take the function takes a row, which is an object, and we test to see if we have certain properties within that object. And if we do, then we'll score that row according to whether we like those property values or we don't. So how do I pull that into my Jupyter Notebook component? Well, I will go back to Pipeline Pilot, and I have some code already pre-prepared where I've got a simplified, shortened version, just looking at one property for that particular score. And here, the key point really is that Pipeline Pilot has prepared for me a data frame called PLP underscore DF, a pandas data frame, with the data from the pipeline. Hence why we had to run the pipeline before we started editing our code. And it gives us that. And in this case, I am going to apply a lambda function to each row. And my function is my calculate MPO. Here, I've only considered one data property, A log P. If A log P is defined, then let's have a look. And if it's less than 3, then I'm very happy with that. And I'll add a whole 1 to the score. If it's between 5 and 0, then we add that divided by 2 to the score. I should probably pause now and remove that. This returns the score, and we create a new property within our panda data frame, CNS underscore MPO. But of course, this being pandas, I can take a look at what that looks like and I can work with it from here. So if I add a print statement here and run that whole thing, what we get is a summary, typical fashion, telling us that the first row has the following properties and ends up with an MPO score of 1. A log P being the only thing we've looked at there, and it is indeed less than 3, so of course we got a 1. Now I'm going to extend that script to the full script. I'm just going to paste that in here from my IDE, and I'm going to run that again. And now we should, rather than being a number between 0 and 1, we now have a number between 0 and 6. 0 meaning none of the properties are suitable. 6 meaning all the properties are in the perfect range. And so here we see our CNS MPO score. Now, I should probably remove that print statement simply because I don't need it for Pipeline Pilot, but I'm happy with that script. So now I say OK to that. I'm going to put a table viewer at the end, and I'm going to take a look at that. And sure enough, that has run away and has produced for me my CNS MPO score for my data.